Hello students, today I brought a lecture for you regarding insertion of chart in PowerPoint. Okay, in this lecture we will be discussing about what are charts, what are the different components of a chart and the ways how we can insert a chart, how we can change the type of the chart, how we can format a chart. Okay, for that first of all we will begin with what is a chart. So basically chart is also called as graph, and chart is a pictorial way to present the data. Data means here we are referring to the numerical data, the data in the form of numbers and figures. Okay, so this chart is going to present the data in graphical form in a meaningful and easy to understand way. Why easy to understand? Because as we say that a picture is worth more than 1,000 words. That means rather than going for the long analysis of the very large amount of data, we can get it very easily with the help of charts. We can draw the different conclusions, we can find the relationships between data, whether the data is increasing, whether it is decreasing, and what kind of relation it is having with the different values. We can accurately analyze the data with the help of chart. And the most important feature of chart is with the change of data, as the data is changed, that chart is also updated automatically. So we need not to make the chart again for the data if it is changed. Okay? So these, first of all, we will be discussing about the different components of the chart. These are the different components: chart title, grid lines, plot area, chart area, x-axis, data series, y-axis, and data label. See, basically this image, that is, it is of a column chart. This is a column chart basically, right? And a column chart is bounded by two axes. Here is the origin point. This horizontal axis is called as the x-axis, and this vertical axis is called as the y-axis. The other name for x-axis is category axis, and the other name for y axis is value axis. It is because we are going to plot the categories in x axis and we are going to plot the values for those categories in y axis. Like for example, in this graph we can say that the title of the chart is how do you like this product. That means it is basically the heading, the topic on which we are making the chart, right? For the first category, it's excellent. We are having the value as 400. The column chart is going to depict the categories on the x axis and values on the y-axis. And then we are having this data series, the value, the series that we are going to plot in our graph. If we want to show the values also on those series, so those are called as data labels. Fine. Then we can see that here we are having some lines behind these columns. These lines are called as grid lines, and these grid lines are provided for the readability of the data. Like for example, here we can see this 25 value is there, and this grid line, first this is indicating the value 50. And this column is somewhere in between 0 to 50. So we have the data is 25. So we can analyze like this. Right? Now we are having the two terms, plot area and chart area. As we can see, a yellow color boundary over here. This boundary indicates the area that is covered by the chart. It includes the chart title. It includes the label for the axis, x-axis label, y-axis label. Fine. So this whole area occupied by the chart is called as chart area. And this red one area that we are having, in which is bounded by x-axis and y-axis, this is called as plot area. So we can say that plot area is a part of chart area. Okay, in other words, we can say that plot area is inside the chart area. Right, so here's a brief description of all these components of chart which I have discussed. Axis, already we have done two type of axis in column charts: category value axis and value axis, also called by the name x-axis or horizontal, value axis by the name y axis, and vertical axis. Then the next component is axis title, which are going to give us an understanding of the data, that what data we are plotting on our axis, whether it is x axis, whether it is y axis. Then we are having chart title, which is going to tell us about that on what topic we are making the chart. Then we are having data series. These are the labels on which we are plotting our graph. Chart area, complete area covered by the chart. The name that is displayed on the x-axis and y-axis is called as category name. Then grid lines, with the help of grid lines, it makes us easy to read the data. Then there is one more component, legend. That is very important component. Fine. It is going to depict the color or patterns that are assigned to the data series. For example, we are plotting a graph in which we are having multiple values to be plotted. So in that case, those multiple values are differentiated with the help of colors or patterns, just like we have a key for the map. In the same way, we are having legend in this graph, right? Then the next component is plot area. That, as I've already discussed, that it is the area inside the chart area, which is going to contain the actual chart bounded by the x-axis and the y-axis. Right? Now we will discuss about the ways how to insert a chart. This is the icon for the chart. Right? We have to find out this icon in either of the ways which we are using to insert the chart. There are two ways basically. The first way is the same like we were going for the table one. We have to go to title and content slide layout of our slide and we have to click the chart icon. The other way is we have to click on insert tab, then we have to click to the chart icon. Now I'll tell you practically how to do that. Suppose this is my slide. Right now we can see that I'm having the title and content layout for this. Already it is done. Right? I can see there are six icons provided over here. I have to click this chart icon to insert a chart. If I'll click on this, I'll get this window. Fine. Suppose I choose another way. I click on insert tab and I click the icon chart here. Again, the same window. That means with either of the way that we are choosing, we are targeted to this common window regarding insertion of a chart. So in this chart dialog box, we are provided with different types of chart. Right now we are working upon column chart, so we will select this. Otherwise we can go for this one also. See the different variants of line chart, bar chart, area chart, XY chart, so many are there. But for the basic concepts, we'll go for the column chart and I'm selecting the first one. Okay. The moment I'll click OK, you will see a change in the screen. Just see here. We can see that we are provided with two sheets now on our screen, both together. This is the screen for the PowerPoint. This is the screen for the Excel. Now, as every chart is based upon some data, so that's why to prepare a chart, we should have our data with us first. Then only we can create a chart. Without data, chart is of no meaning. Fine. Now see here, as you can see that this data, this worksheet is having default data in it. But as we are creating the chart, so obviously we will be creating the chart on our data. So for that, we need to first of all create our data. So there is an option to delete this data. See, here's at this corner, we are having an icon. If I'll click on this, I can see that whole sheet is highlighted with light blue shade. That it is indicating that whole sheet is selected now. Fine. Now I can press the delete key. So we can see that just pressing the delete key, this area of the chart is blank now with no value. Fine. Now I can type my values from here and the chart will be updated automatically. Just have a look over here. Suppose I'm taking the data as, I've taken the data, suppose name. Okay. Then I've taken here weight of certain students I'm taking. Then suppose height. Okay. These are my three values. Suppose name I've taken by default like this. Aman, Ankit, Riya, like this. Suppose three records only I'm taking. Weight suppose 34 kg, 35 kg, suppose 40. Right? And then suppose height I'm taking 125 centimeter, suppose 135 centimeter, and suppose 150 centimeter. Right? Now, as we can see that the moment I was writing the data over here, the same change has been reflected here. Now I can switch over to my Microsoft PowerPoint window. I can maximize it and I can see that my data, my chart has been plotted for the data which I have written. Weight, height, fine. Here we can see that the names are given. Now we can see here that this chart is provided. See, this whole area occupied by this boundary is coming under the chart area. Now we are having these three tabs. Chart tools mein, it is providing us three tabs with the help like design, layout and format. See, if you are not liking this color pattern and all, it is providing you different chart styles. From here we can go for the different styles, whatever we feel suitable for our data. Fine. Now the next thing we can see here that this x-axis is going to display the names Aman, Ankit, Priya. That are the names given over here, and the values for weight and height are displayed in these two patterns. So this is the component legend, as I was talking to you about, that in this graph, this orange color component is indicating the weight, as we can see, and this blue one is indicating the height. Now, this is a basic column chart. Now, if I want to change the size of my chart, I can just click on the corner handle. Fine. If I will be dragging it inwards, the size of the chart will be reduced. Fine. Now, I can see that there are grid lines are there in my chart. Legend is there. X-axis is there. Y-axis is there. But certain components are missing. So how I can add those components? I'll go to layout tab. See here, these are the options under labels group in layout tab, chart title. There are the options where I want the chart. title. Suppose I have given here above chart. Suppose this is the box for chart title. Now I can click over here and I can write the title of my chart. Suppose record of students. I'm simply writing the title as record of students. This is the title of my chart. Axis title, if I want to give, see here we are having two axes in column chart, horizontal axis and vertical axis. Horizontal axis, title below axis I have clicked, and these are the name of student. This is the title of the student. So from here I can add the title as name of students. Fine. Then here on the vertical axis also, if I want to have axis title, then primary vertical axis, go for the horizontal title or vertical if I want to have. I can write the title as, suppose these are the weight and height. Suppose. And if you are not preferring this way, so we can go for the another one, rotated title or simple the horizontal title. Simply like it can come also like this. Right? With this procedure, we can add the different components of the chart. Data table also, if you want to show on your chart, for example, if whatever the data for which I am plotting the graph, if that also I want to show, it can come like this. I click the option data table and I show data table with legend keys like this. Okay, so we can see here that this table is also attached here. Names are displayed here, their weight and height are there, and it is indicating the color pattern that are used in the chart. Now this way I can format my chart. I can apply the different labels to my chart. Fine, grid lines are already added, this horizontal one, but if I want the vertical one also, I can add it from here, like major grid lines. We can see that vertical grid lines are also there. Fine. Now there is an option of format chart tools, as it was giving us three tab: design, layout and format. When I'll go for the format tab and my chart is selected, see, I can apply different patterns from here. You can see from here, okay, like this, whatever color suits your requirement according to your choice. Blue will also not, whatever the color you want, you can take it. Fine. Now there is one option, when I'll right click on my chart, there is one option, see, change chart type. Suppose I have created the chart as column chart, but I need to change it, or I want to change the data. So these are also the option. If I want to change the chart type, again that same dialog box as we have got earlier is open in front of us. And whatever the chart type you feel like, you can change it. Suppose I need a pie chart for this, like this. Fine. So whatever the chart, again, if I want to change it, fine, we can change it. Now the next one, I'm undoing this effect. Fine. One option is there. Fine. Edit data if I want to change my data. Fine. So this way, I can apply different formatting styles to my chart. Now there is one option, how to change the chart type that we have done, pie chart we have done. If I want to select any other type, that also we can do. One more thing, there is an option of format plot area. See, this is the plot area. We can see here this option, format plot area. Plot area is basically this highlighted one. We can see these pointers over here. So this area is indicating the plot area. This out one is chart area. ये जो आपका शेडेड एयर है अलॉन्ग विद द पॉइंटर्स, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज प्लॉट एरिया. नाउ सी व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन आई विल क्लिक ऑन फॉर्मेट प्लॉट एरिया. इट विल गिव मी अ अगेन अ डायलॉग बॉक्स विद द डिफरेंट फीचर्स दैट हाउ आई कैन अप्लाई द फॉर्मेटिंग टू माई प्लॉट एरिया. सी, नो फिल, सॉलिड फिल, ग्रेडियंट फिल. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू फिल द चार्ट विद सम टेक्स्चर, यू कैन सी दैट द चेंज इज रिफ्लेक्टेड हियर. दीज काइंड ऑफ चेंजेस ऑल्सो कैन बी अप्लाइड हियर. वट एवर यू फील अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रिक्वायरमेंट, वी कैन गो फॉर. If we want to insert some picture, we can click from insert from file, then whatever images you have saved, you can take those image, and then you can insert that image at the background of your chart as well. Fine. If you want to change the border styles, solid line, gradient line, fine, that way also you can do shadow. These are the different options in which I can format my plot area. Fine. This is the way how we can change the type of the chart, how we can format the plot area. These three tabs are basically helpful for us, in which through which we can format our chart. The change chart type is option is also provided here under the design tab at the extreme left corner, which is going to open the same window from where I can change my chart to any of the type if I want to change it. Fine, that is a simple change. Now the chart styles are there. Whatever style is preferable, we can choose from here. Okay. So I hope you will understand all these things that I've explained. Fine. Thank you, everyone.